This is a video on multiple workspaces. I start a configuration. And in this case, I have a box object and a workspace. Name is workspace. And a representation of this box in this workspace. And I can activate it when I start the MyBox object. Here I have a link, then the view will be created. If the workspace not exists, it will be created too. I add to it. So now we see here the box here in this workspace. And now I can change some parameters of the box. I can say I change the length to 20 and we have the new object this way. So next step, I copy these two objects. So I have the possibility to create a new workspace. I call it other workspace, and here I have the view, and I can go to the view and can say in this case I want it in wireframe representation, and now I have to connect the execute chain. That means when I change my box, this representation should be updated, and then this should be updated, and I do it. I go again to my box and say execute it. So now we look here. We have here now two windows. Workspace and the other workspace. And we now can change the parameters. That means I select my box here and go here to the values, and I say I change the width to 10. Oh, to 10. And in both views, the object is updated. The height to 3. And so on. So I have the two different representations of the same object. Once more, the big picture. Here we have the cat object, the box. Here we have two workspaces. And we have the representation of the box one time here in this workspace and the other one another time in this workspace. And when I go into the workspace, I can now add some rendering information. For example, I can say wireframe or not the transparency. I can change if this makes sense. Can do it here. I say transparency is 90. Okay. And then I update. And I see here I have transparency 90.